about a revolutionary car copter. Our next guest is ushering in some really cool new transportation opportunities here at CES. The CEO of Mecca, very interesting, is Thierry. I'm going to ask you to say your name properly.
De Boisvilliers, my name is De Boisvilliers.
De Boisvilliers, your last
name. Okay. Exactly.
First name, Thierry?
Thierry.
Thierry, okay. Absolutely correct. tell me a little bit about Mecca, about the company, and then let's get into the cool things that you guys are doing.
Yeah, the company was born in the end of 2020, and the project itself was born in Airbus company, because I'm from Airbus company, and before I was a TAC helicopter pilot.
With Airbus and...
A TAC helicopter pilot in Army Aviation, and then... helicopter industry inside Airbus, and we decided to develop this project of flying car in the racing environment in 2018. We have done 3 years studies. We have done a third mock-up flying since 2019 to validate the architecture of the vehicle. And end of 2020, we decided to create Mecca, an independent company from Airbus, and we are pushing this project, which is to develop a flying racing car. Why in the racing? Because it's much easier to develop a flying car in the racing environment, because in terms of regulation, it's much more easier.
Ooh, so not just a flying car, but a flying race car.
Exactly, a flying race car with a pilot on board and with hydrogen as an energy vector. Because it's not possible today to use batteries in terms of endurance. With batteries, this kind of vehicle, 600 kilograms, will fly a few minutes. But with hydrogen, it will be able to fly longer time. So this is what we are going to do. The pilot on board, hydrogen on board, and it will be a vehicle which will fly at 250 kilometers per hour.
Any idea what that's like in miles per hour and that sort of thing, as we translate it for most of our audience in the U.S.?
Well, we...
Fast.
Fast, yeah. Fast, and we want to make a new spectacle, something new. You know, just like Star Wars, you remember, so we are in Star Wars, and we are preparing the future of transportation.
Well, because we've been hearing about flying cars for many years, but are we really becoming a scenario where it's actually becoming reality at this point?
Yes, we can say that it start being the reality, because the technology is here now, and the regulation is also pushing in this direction. EASA, also FAA, which is the regulation
from the
US. Everybody is pushing in this direction. We have new requirements, and they are really pushing the flying cars, and many companies are developing their own future flying cars. So in a few years, not now, because all the environment is not yet ready, but in the future, we feel that all the ecosystem is pushing really, and we are sure that in around 10 years, we will see flying cars reliable enough, we will fly around us and above our head.
So just slightly into tomorrow, if you will.
Yeah.
Okay, very good. And it seems that there are other companies that are trying to develop flying cars, but it also seems to me that not only with your background, with your aerospace background and so forth, you're piloting an attack helicopter, etc. You seem to have an edge, I think. Mecca apparently has got some good competition.
Yes, exactly. Today there are more than 200 companies who are developing the flying taxis, but we are among the two, three companies worldwide which are focusing on racing, and of course, we have this background, so we know perfectly how to certify a flying vehicle, and this is what we are focusing on. We are discussing with the regulation. We are pushing all the system to certify this vehicle at the highest level of aviation requirements.
Wow, nice. So then, how does the whole race car concept play into this concept? It's all about speed, but also control and the ability to do more.
Exactly. Not only speed, because this kind of vehicle can can fly in different way, you know. It can hover, turn, do whatever you want.
So would you be racing around a typical car racetrack, only you're doing it in the air?
Yeah, alors, what today in Europe, many racetracks are interested in our project. So we know that all the ecosystem of racing are focusing on what we are doing. So we have lots of people who are pushing, and we can imagine this kind of race in desert, and why not on racetrack and anywhere. Finally, we can imagine lots of things. So we are not only developing the project, we are also developing the flying the racing concept.
And of course, you mentioned clean burning hydrogen. So that's an important part of what you guys are working on.
Yes, very important, because with batteries, this kind of vehicle, 600 kilograms, will fly few minutes. But with hydrogen, we will have more endurance, for sure. And this is why we intend to focus and to put on board this sustainable energy.
Gotcha. Well, our audience has got to visit us at intotomorrow.com and see the video of what Terry is talking about, because it truly is fascinating. And it's around the corner, Into Tomorrow, not right away, but it's happening. And it's coming, and you and your company are certainly working on it.
Thank you very much for this interview.
It's our pleasure. And you want to visit macaflight.com, macaflight.com. We'll get you there when you visit us at intotomorrow.com. I'm Dave Graveline. Stay tuned. There's so much more from the show floor at CES in Las Vegas on the Advanced Media Network.